In this video, I'm going to do some sketching with my favorite brush pen, the Kuretake number 13. Alright, in an effort to become a more confident illustrator, drawer, cartoonist, I'm going to jump right into the drawing using only the brush pen, no pencil, no Control Z in Photoshop, straight ink to paper. Wish me luck. Alright, jumping straight into this drawing, straight brush pen on Bristol board. I'm just using a cheap old piece of Bristol board. I think the texture is smooth, so usually with brush pens, I like to grab the vellum textured Bristol board. Using the brush pen on something that has a little more tooth and texture just feels nicer to me, but it's all personal preference. There's not one that's better than the other. This is the Kuretake number 13 fountain brush pen. I know I'm probably saying that wrong. It's a Japanese brush pen. It's kind of on the more expensive side because it is refillable. So it's a pretty nice, it's like around $30 brush pen. It has a nylon tip, so it's not actual animal hair. It's a synthetic tip, but it will last a really, really long time. You can buy really cheap refills, and I've known people in the past that have just filled in the old cartridges with their own ink and used that, but I always just buy the refills because they're super cheap, and the actual brush pen will last a super long time as long as you don't like go too heavy-handed with the tip. So yeah, we're jumping straight into this. I decided, hey, I'm just gonna draw a bunch of goblins. I think they're kind of forgiving anatomy-wise, so, you know, they can have long, weird arms or short little arms and big heads, small heads. You know, they're weird little monsters, so they can look however you want them to look proportionally and all that stuff. So, and plus, I just super love goblins. So the Dungeons & Dragons campaign that I'm running right now is all based around goblins and hobgoblins. And, you know, the characters are doing what they can to slow down this giant goblin army that is tearing its way through the civilized world. Yeah, they're just a great classic D&D monster. There's something about little crazy monsters that maybe don't have a lot going on in their head, but are still super ambitious and want to terrorize and murder. I don't know. They're just a cool enemy. So that's what we're drawing here. Actually, drawing all these goblins makes me think of this new artist I just stumbled upon. His name is Kyle Farron. He goes by D20 Plus Modifier on Instagram. I'll put a link below. He does these awesome, very gestural characters. He draws a lot of goblins and kobolds and lots of fun D&D stuff. I think he did the artwork for this board game called Root. It's a bunch of little personified animals, fantasy world board game. It looks super, super awesome. But yeah, he does these great sketches of monsters and creatures, and there's a whimsy to them and this sketchiness and dashed off kind of feeling, but everything's super confident looking. And so that, I think that was maybe my big inspiration for wanting to do this drawing. Just fill up a page with goblins, go crazy, don't worry about the composition too much, go straight into ink, no sketching, no anything, just sort of do something to try and be more confident. Because usually I spend a lot of time on my illustrations getting everything just right. So, you know, usually I'm doing like a rough sketch, and then I clean up the sketch, and then I pencil it, and then I ink it, and then I make little corrections and everything. So this is kind of, this whole process is definitely out of my comfort zone. I like to be in control. You know, I feel like there's not a lot of stuff in my life, in life in general, that we get to be in control of. You know, putting my imagination onto a page is something that I'm in control of. And, you know, it's stressful when you don't feel like you're in control of it, when you can't get what you want from your head onto the page. And I think this is my attempt at becoming more confident with that. So letting these little mistakes that happen just happen, let it go, you know, let let the drawings be what they are, and, you know, not always have to be in such control of the drawing. And I think the other thing this does, if I keep this up, if I do more drawing like this, just straight in ink, which I think I'm going to do, I think I'm going to, you know, spend some time in my sketchbooks just drawing straight in ink, because I think I'll become a more confident illustrator, just more confident at drawing if I do this. So, you know, I'll get used to things not always working out, and I'll be okay with that. I'll start embracing those happy accidents into my work, maybe, hopefully, instead of spending so much time making every little line just right. I don't know. This is my attempt at loosening up. Now that I'm thinking about all this and just kind of babbling off the top of my head here, these tools like super don't matter. So like, even though I'm drawing with this kind of expensive brush pen, these drawings would be the same or maybe even better if I was just using like a normal whatever kind of pen, right? It had just been a little while since I had used this brush pen, and I thought it would be fun to get back into the thick brush lines of this Kuretake number 13. And actually, I think this is making this even more of a challenge for me. Having to worry about the thickness of the line as I'm drawing just straight from my head it's like almost having to think of too much stuff. So I think, you know, my hand here is kind of shaky, and, you know, these aren't the best brush lines, like not even close to, I think, typically how I would ink with this pen. Everything's very wobbly and weird, but maybe, I mean, that's part of this, is letting go and just going for it. So yeah, don't get too hung up on the tools. It's more about just drawing. Just spend time drawing. This is like so much fun. And I think the more you draw, the more fun you have. Even over the last year, I've been drawing so much more. And a lot of times I've been realizing that, you know, sometimes I don't want to take a break and go play video games or watch a movie or something. I want to just keep drawing. So I think the more you draw, the more you'll get into it, the more awesome it is. The most rewarding thing is being able to take a blank piece of paper and a pen and create something. Being able to make something out of nothing is the best. It's the best. So I haven't quite figured out what I want this YouTube channel to be specifically, but if it is one thing, I hope that it's inspiring people to draw more, to make things, to play Dungeons and Dragons, and to skateboard. Okay, I've rambled on. Let's start wrapping up this time lapse here. If you have any questions about anything, about the brush pen, about paper, any process stuff, or just whatever, leave a comment below. Check out all the links in the description below as well, because I'm going to post Kyle's Instagram and where you can get the brush pen. And okay, the last little thing, off camera, I added in some more slime and fire and stuff just to fill in the empty spaces. You know, the composition of this was not planned at all, so there was a lot of empty spaces, even though I tried to cram as much stuff in there as I could. So added a bunch of slime, added some fire, just some extra stuff to fill it in. So okay, that's it. Here are the goblins. Alright, so that was super fun. I love just drawing with the brush pen, trying to get the feel of thin to thick to thin to wavy lines. Spinning the brush around on the page is super satisfying. There's something about having a blank white page and putting dark black ink on it that's just, I don't know, it's one of the most fun parts of drawing. Hopefully this was cool, fun to watch. I super encourage you to try drawing straight with a pen or with ink, no pencil, no nothing. It forces you to embrace mistakes and just kind of go with it, you know, go with the imperfections of everything that is happening that you can't quite control, even though you are controlling it. You know what I mean. All right, leave a comment down below if there's something you'd like to see me draw in the future. If you'd like to keep up with my drawings on a daily basis, follow my Instagram. That's also down in the description below. Thank you so much for checking out this video, and I'll see you in the next one.